Hey y'all, happy Thanksgiving. Today on the farm we're going to be talking about turkeys. So I have a sweet girl here. She's not used to being held, so she's not liking it too much. So I have two sweet girls like this. Girl turkeys are called hens. She needs a name. Can you help me with names? They both look exactly alike. So these girls are called royal palms. They're really light gray. They're beautiful, and they're really small though, so help me with some names in the comments, or we'll talk about it at school, whichever you think. So turkeys have a lot of the same kind of things that chickens have. They just look a little bit different. So of course they're bigger. Turkeys can get up to 45 or 50 pounds. So we're going to talk about girl turkeys are called hens. Boy turkeys, like Mr. Henry in there, are called toms or gobblers. You could hear them call either one. Baby turkeys are called poults, and so they're called poults until they are grown. So turkeys have this really unusual neck. So they have these, I don't know if you can see, they're like little bumps on their necks, and they have little ears just like chickens do. They have this little thing on their face that's called a snood. It sticks straight up when they're upset or, you know, excited or whatever. They have a really long, pretty beak. They have big, huge feet. Oh, beautiful big feathers. I'm gonna let her go because she's not used to being held. Classic girl. So you help me with names. But my other friend back here, Henry, I hope you can see him. The sun is pretty bright today. So Henry is a black Spanish. Those girls are royal palms, like I said. So he's called a Spanish black. And he's what you think about when you think about turkeys, probably. He's huge. He has beautiful black iridescent feathers with the whites on the tips. I think you can see him. He has a beautiful red and blue head and neck with those same little nodules on them. They don't hurt them. That's just part of what turkeys look like. And his snood gets really, really long. And that's what we call the gobbler. I don't know if you can see him right now. Hey, buddy. You see his big, thick neck, and then he has the wattle that's under there. So Henry came to our farm about a week or so ago from my friends Natalie, Cora, and Riley. And Henry was having a little bit of trouble at his farm, so and I needed a boy turkey. So we got it all worked out, and Henry's come to live with us, and he's doing great so far. The reason that he has to stay in here is because whenever you get new birds or animals of any kind, and you want to put them with your other group of birds or animal, you need to keep them isolated for a week or two. This is just safety for everybody. So during the day, all the other animals, the birds and the chickens, the ducks, and the other turkeys can get around this coop, but Henry can't hurt them and they can't hurt Henry. And a lot of times when you have new animals, that's what they want to do. They want to fight. And so that helps that. It also helps just to make sure no one's sick or anything like that. So if he did have problems of any kind, you know, I would have several weeks to treat him so that he doesn't give that to anybody else. And so that's kind of what we're doing. He's in that quarantine or waiting period. Like I said, he gets to come out in the afternoon once I put everybody else up or let them out of the fence. He gets to come out of here. So it's about time for that. He's ready for that. But I knew that if I let him out that we wouldn't be able to see how beautiful he is. So I wanted to thank my friends for letting Henry come live at our farm. So like I said, our two girls, we need some names for them. So before we read, let's talk about some more turkey facts. So turkeys come from eggs, just like chickens and ducks and geese and all kinds of poultry like that. They are incubated for 28 days instead of 22, like chickens are. They're big eggs too, they're really big. When they're hatched, they're called poults, turkey poults. When they grow up, girls are called hens, boys are called toms or gobblers. Most turkeys that live on farms are called domestic turkeys. There are heritage breeds, which are what the two kinds that I have, or domestic breeds, which are usually the white ones. And this, the kind that you buy at the store are usually the white ones that we use for meat. Kind of like we've talked about chickens, I have both as well. So There's Henry looking all pretty. I don't know if you can hear him. He's making a very loud noise that doesn't sound like a gobble that you might think a turkey sounds like. He's making kind of a screeching noise, and he's stomping his feet and patting, you know, and keeping his feathers out. And that's because the girls are around. He gets really excited when the girls are close by. So I think Henry's going to do great for our farm. So I'm excited that he's here. So do you have turkeys to eat for Thanksgiving? We usually do. But thankfully this year, all the turkeys on our farm are going to stay here. We're not going to be eating them. We want those babies in the spring. So we need a mama turkey and a daddy turkey to have those babies in the spring. So everybody's safe this year. The book that we're going to read today is about having a turkey for Thanksgiving and what some families do. So it's called... There he is. Can you hear him gobbling? Say, hey, Henry. Hey, buddy. A Turkey for Thanksgiving. So I'm going to hold it up so you can see. Hopefully the sun's getting bright. And this is by Eve Munting and illustrated by Diane DeGrout. And here's their little decorations. It was Thanksgiving morning. Mr. Moose helped Mrs. Moose set the Thanksgiving table. Sheep will sit here. He likes the chair that's straight up and down. Mr. Moose said, rabbit here, porcupine here. Mr. and Mrs. Goat will sit here. He smiled at his wife. Isn't it nice to have friends to share Thanksgiving with? I sure do love to have friends and family to share Thanksgiving with. And I'm sure some of your families are doing that, getting the whole house ready and setting up the big tables. That's what we do at my grandma's. We put all the big tables out, all the extra chairs. Mrs. Moose set two paper pilgrims, one on each end of the table. She placed the paper turkey with its great fan on the table between the two candles, and she stood back. They look good, dear, said Mr. Moose. Mrs. Moose sighed. Yes, but I wish we had a real turkey. Everyone else has a real turkey at Thanksgiving. Everyone but us. Mr. Moose nuzzled Mrs. Moose's head. Well, that won't do. I will go this minute and find you your very own turkey for Thanksgiving. So they wanted a turkey. They're going to go get one. Where do you think they'll go? I don't know. Maybe to the woods. Mr. Moose put on his cap and went out. Mist wandered through the bare trees. The cold made his nose water. Rabbit poked his head out from his rabbit hole. Mr. Moose, is it dinner time yet? Not quite yet. Mrs. Moose wants a turkey. I'm off to find one. Rabbit joined him in three quick hops. I'll come too. So now Rabbit and Mr. Moose are going to find a turkey. The woods is a good place to start, isn't it? Moose's warm breath hung white in front of him. Snow crunched under his hooves and made little holes that Rabbit jumped over. I see the goats, Rabbit said. Mr. Goat raised his head and spat out a tin can that he was chewing on. Is it dinner time? He called. No, not yet. Not until I find a turkey, Mr. Moose said. We saw one down by the river, Mr. Goat told him. And Mrs. Goat added, a fat one. So there they are. Now where are they going? Down by the river. So that's where they said they saw one. They got their little house. All these little tires. Oh, there's the sheep. The goats leaped down from the perch. I'll show you. Sheep was further up the hillside, looking around as the fur ball in a winter coat. Is it dinner time? He bellowed. First I have to find a turkey, Mr. Moose bellowed back. There's a turkey nest on the riverbank, sheep called. Wait for me. There they all go. Everybody's getting excited, aren't they, around here? The earth smelled of ice and moss as they crunched along. Above them, a crow hung, black as a puff of wood smoke. Porcupine was hiding in the underbrush. You see him? It's you, he said, and he put his quills down. We're off to get a turkey for Mrs. Moose, Mr. Moose explained. Do you want to come? Well, I'm very slow, Porcupine said. Pick me up on your way back. Who'd want to pick you up anyway, sheep asked, and he laughed and bleated with laughter. I'll wait, Porcupine told Mr. Moose. So Porcupine decided not to go look for a turkey, didn't he? here they all are. He says, do not disturb. No turkey here. Come back after Thanksgiving. What do you think he's trying to do? Can you see him right here? He's hiding. They saw Turkey's nest right away, and Turkey himself peering over the top of it. Turkey, Turkey, Mr. Moose called in the sweetest of voices. Arg! Turkey blurted from his nest and ran. Mr. Moose lumbered after him. Turkey, don't run. We just want to have you for Thanksgiving dinner. Turkey ran even faster. He doesn't want to go to Thanksgiving dinner. What do you think he thinks will happen? Oh, look at this. Mr. Moose saw the red and the blue sheen of Turkey's neck. Turkey's tail brushed crumbs of snow behind him, and he tried to fly. Too fat, said Mr. Goat. Turkey's legs bent in the middle and he fell. Mr. Moose put a booted hoof on his head and he smiled his great toothiest smile. I hope you don't have other plans for Thanksgiving. Oh, poor Turkey. He looks so sad. What does he think they're going to do? He thinks they're going to eat him, doesn't he? He helped Turkey up. My wife won't mind that you're too fat, he said. Let's go. It's getting very close to dinner time. They marched Turkey in front. I'm sorry about this, for I can see you don't want to come, Mr. Moose said. But I must insist. A promise is a promise. Turkey's still very nervous, isn't he? And they're pushing him. Everybody else is happy. They got a turkey. There was a wreath of dried fruit on the Moose's door. Inside the house was filled with Thanksgiving smells. Mr. Moose hid Turkey behind him. Look what I brought you, Mrs. Moose, he said. Sheep, the goats, rabbit, and porcupine, and ta-da! He pushed Turkey around in front of him. Just for you, a turkey for Thanksgiving. Can you see him? Oh, he's so scared. Poor Turkey, so scared. Looks very worried, doesn't he? Mrs. Moose clapped her hooves. Oh, I'm so happy to have you, Turkey. Thank you, Mr. Moose. Now everything is just perfect. Shall we sit? Sheep asked, heading for the straight up and down chair. Let's, said Mrs. Moose. Rabbit, sit here. Porcupine, here. And Mr. and Mrs. Goat, here. And look, I brought a chair from the other room in hopes of a turkey. A chair? He said. Right next to me, Mrs. Moose said. Light the candles, Mr. Moose. He looks so surprised, doesn't he? So surprised. There were bowls of acorns and alfalfa sprouts, dried since summer. There was a willow bark and cured grasses with wild parsley. There were pressed leaves, thin and pale as nice ice on the pond. They got a lot of veggies, don't they? I hope you find something here to your liking, Mr. Turkey, Mrs. Moose said. I wasn't sure of your taste. You are so kind to worry about my taste, the turkey said. I thought you'd be worried about how I would taste. Poor turkey, he's just overwhelmed, isn't he? He looks so happy now, though. Heavens no, said Mr. Moose, as he smiled a big toothy smile and filled everyone's cup with cold spring water. It's so nice to have friends around our Thanksgiving table. Turkey's waddles wobbled. It's even nicer to be at your table and not on it, he said. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Oh, that turkey is so relieved. Happy Thanksgiving, Turkey. Well, I hope you all have learned a little bit about turkeys. And I hope that you have a wonderful Thanksgiving with your family and friends. And I'll see you when we get back to school. Love you. Bye.